Cybercrime is on the rise. According to IT experts, the telecoms and banking sectors are the most susceptible to cybercrime. But individuals are also targets. Individuals who are going about their business on the internet could still be targets for these cyber attacks. We sit down with our head of cybersecurity here at Vision Group to tell us, how can you avoid being a cyber target? Welcome, Mr. Cliff Muganwa.
Hi, everyone. My name is Emmanuel Cliff Muganwa. I'm the IT security manager for Vision Group, but as well double as the director in the Cybersecurity and Forensics Association of Uganda, where our core focus is basically to teach everything cyber-related, cyber fraud and forensics here.
Now, the Computer Misuse Act and Penal Code was recently amended to include punishments for people who are doing cyber attacks on social media and other computer applications. That all involves cybersecurity. So what is cyber attack?
Basically, a cyber attack is the use of technology, I would say, because people confuse cyber with internet, but the use of any means of technology to create harm in any way on a second or third party. In a nutshell, that's cybersecurity. Although increasingly we are seeing cyber attacks happening on two fora, which is mostly on phones, SIM cards basically, as well as on the internet. So there's two things you can use to describe cyber attack, but it's usually general use of technology in any way, in a bad way to miss where it's misused basically, to try and take advantage of someone in any way. Yeah.
According to IT experts, the telecoms and banking sectors are the most prone or susceptible to these cyber attacks. How common is it that a random person could be a target?
Increasingly, because technology is quickly improving over the last couple of years. I would even say in the last 2 years, we've had a transition in terms of technology improvement that is equivalent to about 10 years worth. So the processing, computer processing is increasing now because you have the power of a computer on your phone. It is quite easy now. Even novices can do it. So the rate of increment of cyber attacks is about 100% now, every couple of months. Yeah, so even like I said, novices can do it because they have access to all these free tools, all these free gadgets, quick processing gadgets. So it is becoming a way of life now. It's like oxygen now.
What are some of the most common applications where random persons are most prone to attack?
Because most people are now holding smartphones. Initially, it used to be SIM card attacks, where people used to steal your mobile money on those small cavity phones. But I think the increment in the number of smartphones has created a bigger problem, where now it's mostly use of mobile applications. So you are looking at bank applications, you're looking at mobile money applications. Cyber goes beyond just the thefts, because thefts is the commonest, because the motivation is to steal, but sometimes it is to, you know, drag your name through the mud. I don't know how you term that. Sometimes it is embarrass, basically. Sometimes it's to kill someone's reputation. So social media is very big in terms of cyber hacks. Email. So this is the commonest, basically. You're looking at mobile money apps in Uganda. You're looking at banking apps. You're looking at email and social media, most especially.
Cliff, how can I be safe?
Safety is in so many ways. One, in my experience, a cyber hack is two-way. Most times, it is so rare for a cyber hack to be instigated by just the attacker without you, the victim, playing part. So the first thing you need to know is that hacks happen when you help the attacker to get into your gadget, first of all. So it is, most times I sit down as an ethical hacker, or I forgot to say I'm a certified ethical hacker as well. So as a hacker, I'll sit down and craft an attack, but you have to let me in. So I'll either send you a phishing email, deceiving you that you have won something, and because you're also gullible, you know, how do you win something you've not competed for? You'll then click on a link and allow me to access your bank account. Or I'll send something to your phone and then you install it. Or you're going to install an application from Google Play or wherever, but you are not looking at the downloads or at those apps have ratings. So you look at the ratings. If it's a banking application, why should the banking application have less than 10,000 downloads for a bank that has millions of users? So there are thresholds that you need to look at in terms of you protecting yourself.
For you who has been watching us, do not open the door when the hacker knocks. That has been this week's News Digest.